Welcome to the SOFiSTiK reinforcement detailing presentation. In this video, I would like to show you how you can automatically generate an alternative tagging for reinforcement. First, I want to point out where from you can set up this option. In Settings, Layers, Rebar Sets on the right side where you see the checkboxes, I mark the layers for which I want to have an alternative style. Let's run the command hide and tag and see what happens. All tags are generated. We can notice for the reinforcement, which is assigned to the previously checked layers, we have dashed lines. There is a bit of adjustment needed to obtain a nice clean layout of the plan. To arrange the labels on the desired position, we simply select it and with drag and drop, we can move the labels using the grip of the elements. I am doing this for all the labels in the layout. It might be possible that two labels overlap themselves. To fix this, we select one of it and in Properties window by Dimensions, Position Interior Rebar, we can change the value of the parameter. This parameter indicates in percent where the representation of the rebar should be drawn. I do fast forward all the necessary adjustments to have a readable plan and to avoid the ambiguous labeling. We can be sure though that every element has only one label and the only thing that remains for us to do is this arrangement, which you can see it goes very quickly. Now I want to show you another new feature in SOFiSTiK reinforcement detailing. In section, I want to label the reinforcement and to have next to the label also a small hint of how the position looks like. We set this up by checking in Settings, Annotation, Annotation Shape, the box for Display Reinforcement Shape next to Annotation. In my example, it seems already checked, so let's see how it's working. We activate the section we want to annotate and simply click on Tag All. In the same manner, we do the adjustment to obtain the desired arrangement. If I have something selected, the command works only for the selected elements. This could be useful in case I don't want to have all the rebars annotated with the shape next to the label. Finally, in the ground view, I repeat the same process. As you can see, when I move or rotate the label, the reinforcement shape detail follows the label accordingly. You probably already know that with hide and tag command, there is not created a multi-rebar annotation where only one rebar is unhidden. Instead, all the rebars are hidden and we have a 2D annotation symbol pointing the lane as detailed item and a label as structural rebar tag. This representation is acting although exactly like an MRA, multi-rebar annotation, when changing the detail level from fine to coarse. I will show this to you in all our views. I hope you like this presentation. If you have any comments or feedback, please leave it below or send us an email to support@sofistik.com. See you soon. Bye.